Whether it's just a light trickle or a sudden heavy flow, a nosebleed is a common experience for people at any age. They often occur without warning and can look a lot scarier than they really are. While they can be startling, especially for children or anyone unfamiliar with them, most nosebleeds are not serious and can be easily treated at home. Your nose is normally lined with tiny, delicate blood vessels that sit close to, but beneath, the mucosal surface. These vessels help warm and humidify the air you breathe, but because they're so fragile and close to the surface, they're also easy to damage. 90% of nosebleeds originate from the anterior septum, where blood vessels congregate in a region known as Kiesselbach's plexus. When a nosebleed occurs from this region, direct pressure by pinching the nose is the best way to control and stop it. Because 90% of nosebleeds occur in Kiesselbach's plexus, one needs to pinch as much of the soft part of the nose as possible to ensure you are applying direct pressure to where the nosebleed is coming from. That means to pinch the nose here, just beneath the nasal bones and all the way to the nostril openings, not here, or here, or here. Tilting the head forward or backwards does not help stop nosebleeds. It just directs which way the blood flows due to gravity. Tilting the head back causes blood to flow into the throat. Tilting the head forward causes blood to flow out the front of the nose. If these anterior nosebleeds are recurrent, silver nitrate cauterization will often fix the problem by chemically burning the area. . 10% of nosebleeds occur from other areas of the nose, including the anterior or posterior ethmoid arteries, as well as the sphenopalatine artery. These nosebleeds are more difficult to control at home, as direct pressure cannot be accomplished to these regions by simply pinching the nose. As such, an ER visit is often required where packing or cauterization may be attempted. Packing works by applying direct pressure from inside the nose. Cauterization attempts to seal close the culprit vessel by burning it with electricity. Rarely, surgical ligation and/or embolization may be needed.